Good morning, John, and sorry for this unscheduled video, but as you know, Neil Armstrong has died, and it's super sad. And I wax poetic all over the place in my video on SciShow, so if you want to see that, you can go see that. But now, instead of talking about the symbolic nature of this grape, I just want to talk about how Neil Armstrong was pretty freaking badass. He did many amazing things, of course, but today we're gonna talk about the six most amazing things that Neil Armstrong ever did. Number one, the first amazing cool thing that Neil Armstrong ever did is that he got his pilot's license before he was legally allowed to get his driver's license, which is pretty amazing. And a great way to get a leg up on the competition if you want to become the first man on the moon, which I'm sure was not his goal when he was 16 years old, but still. But in addition to helping him out, you know, getting to the moon, it also ensured that he would be the youngest person in his squadron in the Korean War, where he flew 78 missions, one of which ended when he got hit by artillery fire, had to fly all the way back to base, and then eject because there was no way for him to land the plane. Number two, while working as a test pilot for aircraft, Neil Armstrong flew over 200 different types of planes. And during that particular career, he almost died around three times. Once when he and Chuck Yeager were doing a touch-and-go landing in a salt flat that was muddy. Once when his X-15 bounced off the atmosphere, sending him 40 miles off course with limited fuel reserves. And once when he was landing his plane and the landing gear collapsed underneath him and he had to power out of the landing, smashing the tail of his plane on the runway, destroying the radio, and releasing his hydraulic fluid. Yeah! Number three, and another time that Neil Armstrong almost died, Gemini 8, of which Neil Armstrong was the command pilot. It was the first mission to ever dock two vehicles together in outer space, and as soon as it happened, they started spinning uncontrollably. While spinning at one revolution per second, that's pretty sickeningly fast, Armstrong aborted the mission, separated the craft, corrected the roll, and then headed into the atmosphere, saving his and his pilot's life. Number four. Now, when they were planning on how to build the lunar lander, they had this test thing called the LLRV, and it was basically just a chair strapped to a jet engine. While test driving that thing, one of the little jets on the side failed. Armstrong had to try and get the thing right side up for a moment so that he could eject, and this happened like 30 feet above the ground before the thing hit the ground and exploded into a giant ball of fire. Later analysis showed that if he had ejected 0.5 seconds later, he would have died. But that's not even the amazing part. Neil Armstrong, after that, did a little bit of a press conference with some reporters and then went back to work. People came by and they were like, "Dude, I heard that you almost just died. What are you doing here?" And Neil's like, "I had some paperwork to do." Number five, Neil Armstrong threatened to sue his barber. Now this sounds like kind of a jerk move. Dude's been cutting your hair for 20 years, gives you one bad haircut, and you threaten to sue him? But no, he threatened to sue him because the guy took some of Neil Armstrong's hair and sold it to a celebrity hair collector. Neil found out about it and he's like, "You get me my hair back, or you donate that money to charity, or I will sue your barbershop right out from under you." And unable to retrieve the hair, the guy donated the $3,000 to charity. Good on you, Neil. Good on you. And finally, number six, Neil Armstrong walked on the freaking moon. But before he did that, he landed the LEM on the moon. In order to do that, he had to override the computer, just like Luke Skywalker being like, "I'm gonna use the Force!" Because the computer was taking them down into a crater with big, like, car-sized rocks in it, and he, like, diverted. Everybody's freaking out. What's Neil doing? He gets there, lands the LEM, 30 seconds of fuel left. 30 seconds away from our first foray into the, like, another world, ending in tragedy, in having two men still dead on the moon, their bodies still there. Imagine the impact that would have had on our national psyche. But that's not what happened, because Neil Armstrong was a frickin' badass. John, I'll see you on Tuesday.